Before we jump into the code examples, let me show you a few tricks to debug our code more efficiently in case you run into issues. So consider we have the following setup here, where we have a bias unit, a training data set consisting of 1,000 features with 500 rows, so 500 training examples, and we have the weight vector corresponding to the 1,000 features, so there are 1,000 weight values. So let me insert this little bug into our code. So what I'm doing here is I'm setting the 11th feature value of the 11th data point to A. This doesn't make sense, but I'm just introducing a bug. And now I wanted to show you different techniques we can use to find bugs like that. So let's actually create our buggy training set and then define a function that makes use of our data set. So here, let's now call this function, and hopefully we will see there will be a bug. So in real life, these bugs might be subtle. Of course, we know what the bug is, but this is really just for illustration purposes. Now, what we see here is a type error. It says we can't multiply a sequence by a non-integer of type float. So how can we debug this code? Well, one simple way of debugging is just inserting a print statement. So what we can do here is we can actually print the outputs each time, or we can print xj and wj, because we don't know, so we pretend here, we don't know where the bug occurs. So let's use a print statement to find out where our error is. So executing this code will actually produce a lot of output because we have a very large training set. So finding this bug here might be very tedious. So we see there is a lot of output, and this is sometimes a little bit too much for our code editor even, so it might even crash our computer if we have a huge data set. However, this is one way we can find the bug. We can now see, okay, we still get the same bug as before, and then we see, okay, there is something weird about that particular training example, and we should fix that. So print statements are, let's say, a first aid for debugging, but they're not the most efficient way to debug code. So let me show you a different way for debugging code using PDB, where PDB stands for the Python debugger. So let's consider our function again and modify it so that we can use the PDB to debug it. So for this, I prefer to wrap the crucial line in a try except context. And then I like to use the postmortem method from PDB. So now let's run this code and see what happens. Now we can see we entered the interactive debugger here at the point where the code encountered the error. So now we can actually explore the different values here. So for example, I can print out the different values at this point for wj, the variable we have up here. So I can say p w underscore j, where p stands for print. So we can see here the value for wh is 0.10. There's nothing suspicious about that. Now let's print out the other value here. Let's print out the value of xj. So we can see here, we find, okay, there is something suspicious. So because x underscore j shouldn't be a string variable. So we efficiently now found our bug. The only thing is we have to know at which index position we are. So also, this is information we can print easily here. So we can print the row index, and we can also print the column index. And this way we can find this bug efficiently in our training set. And then once we are done, we can exit the debugger by typing exit. So yeah, this was a quick tour into debugging. So I showed you the two classic ways of debugging code in Python. If you are using Visual Studio Code, JupyterLab, or PyCharm, there are also visual debuggers that you might find helpful. We will include more information about these in the resources if you are interested in checking these out.